Prayer of the Shy Forest. As a child, when I closed my eyes to pray, I saw a hissing wall of TV snow. The tighter I closed them, the harder it hissed. A song with two notes, ah, ya, ya, ya. But I kept coming back, like I kept playing, I know you are, but what am I, with my older brother who never lost, because I'm not your real brother, dork. Kept coming back. Jesus, I made you a drawing of our yard. Kept on till the day Bigfoot, made of prayer snow, strolled through the prayer snow. Bigfoot? Ah, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, well, I knew it wasn't indifference. Bigfoot was shy, like coyotes and me. I promised him I'd only pray for things I really needed, and I'd never sneak up on him and scream, "Pay attention!" like my tap dance teacher did, right in my ear when I was listening to Feelings. Wholly enwrapped, captivated. People who do that can go to hell. This poem squishes together two vivid scenes from my childhood. If I set out to write about a single idea, the poem rarely sets up. Maybe because the process lacks discovery. But if I bring together two ideas that have been existing in my mind independently, all bets are off. Introducing these two memories to each other in the empty room of the poem felt like healing.
So tell me about your hat.
Oh, I went down to Gatlinburg, Tennessee, went to Dollywood and stuff.
Oh, okay.
Looking for one of these hats for so long.
Anna, welcome to the Lo-Fi Lounge. How are you doing, my friend?
I am doing wonderful. How are you?
I'm excellent. The reason we're here is I was looking at the poster for, and it'll come up on the screen when I'm talking about it. I was looking at the poster for Camp N9, and I really liked the poster. I go, this is a very cool poster. And I wrote to Valina. Yet when I was talking with Patrick Judy, he said, I think I met the person who did the poster in an elevator or something.
Oh, yeah, I live in Athens, but my dad and aunt came down all the way from Maryland. We'll get into this. It's crazy. Okay. My connection with Cracker is so strange, but they're both staying at the same hotel. And my dad just sensed that he was a crumb in the elevator. It was
That's
funny.
Pretty cool. So tell me more about your Cracker connection.
Okay. So, My dad's been a fan like my whole life. He loves Cracker. So I went to the Camp Out East, the first Camp Out East in 2011.
Yeah.
I think it was the first time Lowery performed his solo stuff. Uh-huh. I was 2011. I was like a child.
Thank you. surveyed the Sinawan. Home and school the children, give them weapons training. Just in case a DEA comes snooping around again. Go up on the mountain where the waters come from glaciers blue.
I do remember it being fun. It was at like a campground. And I met him there, and I don't know, it just, so, and then I saw him again in 2019 in DC, the 930 Club. And then I wound up going to UGA and he teaches here.
Yeah.
I'm not from, I feel like it would be less weird if I was from Georgia, but coming that far and he just happens to teach here. And I love the music scene in Athens, but it's been just some strange connections.
Kind of get, how did you get that gig and how did you get that idea?
So I think I just happened upon the, well, my dad had been texting me about the camp in. He's like already making plans to come down and let's get the 3-day pass. It was really exciting. And I think it was like early February, I reached out to Valina and I was just on a whim asking if she wanted a poster because I hadn't seen anything. That'd be cool. Because I know in the past they've had like really cool artists, right, like Wes Fried, I think.
Michael Wirtz, also some of the camp, some of the campouts in California, the Pioneer Town ones, have had very cool posters too.
So I just thought I'd reach out and see if they were even interested. And, yeah, as far as the design goes, the Kerosene Hat album is my favorite cover. It's just the colors and the vibe of it is so, I just love it. And it has that like collage aspect to it.
Right, right.
And I was thinking like camping and camping and the kerosene oil can. So like oil lamp, I don't know. I was just like, I want it to look a little like woodsy and camping vibes.
Yeah.
I had a lot of fun with it.
Which is
like really rough little sketches of like, you know, a composition. They were really rough, but she was like, you know what, I trust you. seeing people in 3 consecutive days at all the events, and I start recognizing them, and I talked to some of them, and they were like, oh, you made the poster. It was really special seeing the Hendershots meet and greet. Uh-huh. Seeing everyone with my poster when they were getting them signed, I was like, whoa. I liked remaining a little bit like mysterious though. Some people knew that I did the poster, but otherwise it was just cool to be there.
Well, I think it's something about artists is they're kind of nervy.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. Art, you feel like an artist at art?
Yeah. music, digital. I actually just started digital. I painted this digitally, but it's very new to me. Yeah. I'm used to traditional work, but I'm going into, I actually go to UGA for scientific illustration. That's why I came this far. They don't really offer that program many other places, but so yeah, digital is a big part of the scientific illustration world, like illustrating, just as far as like speed goes, it's more convenient nowadays.
So you play music too?
I dabble.
Yeah.
If you dig hard enough, you can find a cover. You don't have to dig that hard. My dad posts like concert videos all the time, and somewhere in there, I did a cover of "Ah, You Left Me" from the Palace Guards album.
Oh, David Lowery's album. Yeah.
I think that's a cover though. I love music. I really want to improve my guitar, but we'll see. Being a college student is intense. In my art classes, I'm feeling a lot of like finding my own creative style and like narrowing down what I like to do. But as the scientific illustrator part, I'm in like an anatomy and physiology, and it's making me like, that's my next unit, the skull.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, thankfully we have a cadaver lab, and thankfully they don't show us the cadaver's heads. It breaches privacy, but also I think that would be really disturbing. My favorite song. Cracker, my favorite Cracker song for forever has been Movie Star. It's nice. Just, it's so silly.
Everyone said she was beautiful, even without her head. Everyone said she was dangerous. Well, the chief of police kept the crime off the streets. Deep in his heart, we all knew he felt differently.
We all knew he was an anarchist.
Well, I'd like to devour you, but you probably devour.
And I remember going on hikes with my dad, and he'd put, he had his little MP3 player that it was always playing. So it's always been familiar. It's a very unique experience. And now that I'm actually my own person and I'm cognitive and making my own decisions, and I'm deciding to still listen to Cracker, even though my dad listened to them. Yeah. Not dissing him, though. He's got a wonderful music taste, but he does get a little cocky about it sometimes. I won't lie. But I guess that's why I'm a music head now, too. So, but yeah, you were talking about demographics. I felt like a little out of my element in the 40 watt those three nights. I was probably one out of five 20-year-olds there, but I really enjoyed it. It was a great energy in there. When Thayer showed up, it was like she had just gotten there, and David Lowery was like, get on stage, and they started playing that one circus song.
One, two, three, four.
Care at all.
struck by lightning. When he bears his scars, we are them. When he bears his scars, he is a star.
I bought one of her CDs because it was her new album, and she I asked her to sign it, and she gave me a little print and like I think it was like a pastel or pastel chalk piece that she did, and she just gave it to me for free, and I was like, oh my gosh, thank you.
Yeah.
Because I feel like well-rounded artists like dabble in everything, you know.
Well, I sense that in you you're open for ideas and suggestion, and you're.
I didn't even mention that I'm a radio DJ. I could have promoted my show. Oh. I just do a little rotation shift at UGA's WUOG 90.5. But I Lowery gave me his new solo album for free. Thank you. I guess it's a nice gesture because I did the poster, but yeah, I've been playing it on air. It's sweet.
And I should have got down on my knees and thanked the Lord, cause it don't last long. Enjoy it while you can. It don't last long. Enjoy it while you can. Don't last long. It don't last long. Enjoy it while you can. It don't last long. Last long. Enjoy it while you can. It don't last long.
Yeah, I'm 9 a.m. on Sundays. DJ Chiroptera.
Yeah, we'll do another interview when you're further into your career.
Next time I make an album cover or something.
Because we're working on a new album right now. Hey, I might need an album cover.
Hey, keep me on the radar. Thank you, Chris.
Thank you, Anna.
Have a good day.
You too.
Bye.
Nice hat.
Cause it don't last long. Enjoy it while you can. It don't last long. Don't last long. Enjoy it while you can.
Talking with Anna was a lot of fun because it took me back in time to when I was in my 20s. I mean, Johnny Hickman and very young Bob Venom and Bob Jarvis Dad were first doing the Dangers. And then flash forward to 2009 and one of my favorite Dangers albums, the Blue Album, where Johnny and I got together to do a song. It's called Wandering Around.
all night, close to the brink. I close my eyes, I try not to think. Reaching for you, I almost touched down. The moon won't stop wandering around. You look good, asleep in that chair. Faint expectations rise in the air. When you awake, I won't be found. This moon won't stop wandering around. Wandering around, wandering around. All through the evening, never a sound. Oh, come here, my child. Head down, we'll stop this wandering around. You were right, I can't be read. Close that book, lay it down by your head. You were the story, and you I was bound. Stop wandering around. Oh, my friend, your time has been true. Everything right goes straight back to you.
Straight back to you.
Maybe in dreams we'll cover that ground. But the moon won't stop wandering. Wandering around, wandering around. All through the evening, never a sound. Well, come home, little child, won't you lay your head down? We'll stop this wandering around. If I pray, and when I die, you can have all these tears that I cry. One heart was lost, one will be found. So much for wandering around. Wandering around, wandering around. Child, won't you lay your head down? We'll stop this wandering around. We'll stop this wandering around.